And so it begins. IBM just announced that they're going to slash thousands of jobs because they're in a position where they're ready to use AI, artificial intelligence, to replace a significant part of their workforce. As far as software building, all that stuff, they're at a point where they're not going to hire more people to fill roles that AI can take over. And what they're basically saying is they were on the forefront of a technological evolution that involved cloud, involved other technologies. So they're saying now AI is the future. And when you look at it, it's not just technology. It's actually across the board. It's when you look at artificial intelligence and automation and its potential to replace workers, a lot of these companies are looking at ways of replacing workers because they can make money that way. They can replace a person with AI and make a profit. That's all they really care about. That's what it comes down to. And it's not just, oh, technology. It's definitely computers and things like that. But, you know, everything from, like, forestry. I looked this up. Like, forestry, social sciences, even production to a lesser degree, production, actually, which is really interesting. Automation and AI, that percentage, the percentage of that workforce that can be replaced easily with AI and automation is, what, around 10 or 11%? I thought that was really interesting. But the social sciences, apparently, that number is actually pretty high. I thought it was pretty bizarre. So about a quarter of the workforce can actually be replaced with automation and artificial intelligence. So when I did that previous video talking about, oh, you know, the power elite want to replace, they want to reduce the population. I wasn't just talking about black people. This is how they're going to be able to do it, really. They're going to have the technology, automation, AI in place that will help them as far as production, produce everything that they need to produce. They have the machines in place. They'll just need mostly need humans for the technical maintenance and things like that. Man, they're going to get to a certain point where they can even they can actually program machines to build machines or repair machines. So it'll be really self-sustaining. The only question is how long will it take for the AI to become self-aware and basically decide, hey, I don't need these pesky humans anymore. I mean, that's the question at hand. But anyway, that's something that was on my mind. Bank failures. Really interesting. Bank failures. It's not just First Republic Bank. There's other banks that are failing as well. Across the board. Some significant losses. Their stocks are taking a plunge. I think it's Pacific. One of those banks is actually going down pretty hard. Actually, Pacific West. Their stock dropped, 20%? Also, Western Alliance. Their stock dropped significantly. Some Metropolitan Bank also dropped. There's a number of banks that are suffering, so it's not just a lot of regional banks too. And what happened with First Republic is that it's the 14th largest bank. What happened was that when they failed, FDIC took a lot of their assets and put them in the hands of Chase. So what happens is these regional banks or these smaller banks fail, and the big banks end up getting even bigger. So that's what's going to happen with these regional banks. We're not going to have a lot of regional banks anymore. When this is all over with, you're probably going to have it's going to be like network television. It's going to be like television. You're going to have basically four or five big banks in America that pretty much control all the assets. That's what I think you're going to have when this whole mess is all over with. And that way, the big banks will always be bailed out because they're too big to fail. If they fail, the system can't really hold it. The system can't take it. So that's what we're going to end up with. Just like when you research television, the companies, the entities that produce television, you basically have Disney. At one point, you just have a handful of companies who own all these different networks, all these different news stations, all these different media companies. You just have a handful. And that's what you're going to see in banking. You'll see more of that. That whole situation is going to escalate. So there's serious trouble in banking right now. Housing. Home prices actually went up recently. So it's sort of a new thing. It actually went up because they've been struggling for a while. When you look at home prices, they're still 30% below the pre. They're still pretty low compared to its trajectory. But anyway, they had a recent uptake. And I think the average house stays on the market for just a couple weeks or so. So they're not having any trouble selling these houses. Whether it's a good move or not, hey, that's up to you guys to sort of comment on that, whether you think it's a good move or not. But these are definitely some things on my mind. Oh, Robert Kennedy Jr. Okay, Robert F. Kennedy Jr. He's at 20% in the polls. 20%. Biden, of course, is around 80%, 70, 80%. Biden doesn't really have any other challengers. At this point, I think Robert F. Kennedy Jr. is sort of like the anybody but Biden candidate. because when you look at the polls, if you have any faith in them anymore, about 70% of Americans would prefer if Biden didn't run again. And most Americans don't want Trump running again. Most people don't want to see a rematch of Trump and Biden. And I voted for Trump twice, and I don't want to have to endure a third campaign, to be honest with you. I was sort of sick of a lot of his antics when he ran in 2020. I thought, okay, if he wins, it'll be probably better for the country. And at least I don't have to hear about this craziness again. Now we're going to have to subject ourselves to a third campaign, which is kind of depressing, you know. Speaking of campaigns, the Heritage Foundation. One of the big problems with the Trump campaign was that he wasn't organized in hiring good people who can actually implement his policy. The Heritage Foundation, a conservative organization, they're actually heading up the effort to make a better transition. So if the Republicans ever win again, this Project 2025 is going to help them with the transition. It's going to help them recruit some quality people who can actually implement a conservative policy. People who are focused on implementing a conservative policy, not necessarily people who are just loyal to D.C. And that was one of the problems that Trump had. It's weird that Trump couldn't hire good people. He was on he had his own TV show where the whole premise behind the show focused on hiring the right people for a job. And here he gets into the White House, and he can't even hire the right people. I just thought that was really bizarre. Anyway, but home prices rose for the third straight time in March. You guys share your thoughts on the home prices, and do you trust this Heritage Foundation? Do you really trust that? Because I want to know if they're going to put a bunch of neocons in place. Because if that's the case, it doesn't matter if DeSantis becomes president or Trump becomes president. It matters to a certain degree because Trump isn't really a warmonger. But if they got a bunch of neocons all throughout government, it's going to undermine any president who's trying to do something different. That seems to be the case. Republican or Democrat, there's always some neocon just popping up and just running the show. It's completely frustrating. So those are some of the things that are going on in the media right now. Things are pretty much on my mind. I'm driving through Georgia. I'm going to do some more drive-along videos where I show you the road and everything. It's nice. It's nice being away from the mountains, you know, because I like not being around all those narrow roads. This is a different. This is more like what I'm used to. The roads aren't super narrow. The roads are in decent condition. Although certain parts of I-75 is really annoying. This way, it's not that the road's in bad shape. It's just the concrete. The separation of the concrete is like anyway. You have to drive through there to know what I'm talking about. It's not as smooth as this road right here. So. Yeah, some people have some questions for me about my move down here to Georgia. I'll talk a little bit about that. I will get around to doing a live show. It's definitely something I want to do. And again, you know, I'm working every day, and then I go to the gym, and I just want to relax. It's not like it was when I was working 40 hours a week, where I had the whole weekends off. It's not like that anymore. I don't work every day pretty much. This weekend, this week we finally got some new people hired, so I'm gonna be able to get some help. I still want to stop by on the weekend, because I just want to stop by. I'm one of those people. It's gonna be a while before I get to the point where I actually have a whole weekend off. But hey, it is what it is. I am enjoying the food down here. I will say that it's a nice change of pace. Somebody asked me would I want to live inside of the city of Atlanta, and you know I would if I had a lot of money. If I had a whole lot of money, I wouldn't mind having a nice spot in downtown Atlanta. But, you know, the prepper in me doesn't really want to be in the downtown area, really. Even if I did have more money, I would probably want to be like an hour outside the city. I like being within an hour of the city, whether it be north, west, east, south, whatever. like being, I like having access to an airport. I like having access to the amenities of a city. But I don't know if I really want to always be in the center of it. The cool thing about this area is that there's still some medium-sized cities around here that have access to. Some decent-sized cities. So Atlanta itself only has about 500,000 people in it. But the metropolitan area has 6 million. So it's a large metropolitan area. The airport's a major hub for a lot of airlines. And there's a lot of different options. If you're looking for a medium-sized city, smaller cities, you have that in this area. So something I definitely want to explore. So this is what's on my mind right now. It's really interesting. I think about Tucker Carlson and Fox News. Fox News, they're releasing some videos. I think they're trying to slander the guy, trying to make the guy look bad. And yeah. It clearly isn't working. It really isn't working at all. I'm surprised Tucker Carlson was able to stay on air as long as he was able to. That's what really surprised me. I never understood why they let him stay on air. Like, what was the deal? But I guess his time ran out. It will be interesting to see what else he does. What is he going to do next? So, yes, I do have plans to get a really nice camera, but, I mean, that's on the agenda. I mean, there's a number of things on the agenda, but I want to get a really good mic, really good camera. But, yeah, I mean, rent is really high down here, like, really high. Like, I paid rent today. I was like, oh, my goodness. But it's the type of money I would expect to pay if I was living in, like, a super nice area. Anyway, thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.